Hey folks, it's Brian Gregg, here with another RWD screencast to talk about web workers. For those of you unfamiliar with web workers, they are a JavaScript implementation that is used for creating multi-threaded applications. So if that is news to you, congratulations, you have stumbled upon a great feature of modern JavaScript. And we're going to talk a little bit about what that means and how they can actually be implemented. So let's start with a little bit about what are web workers. They're basically snippets of code that run in the browser that can be used to communicate between the main application and a thread using sending and receiving messages. So they implement the observer pattern, allowing the worker to notify the main thread when something has changed, and vice versa, allowing the main thread to post data to the worker thread and listen for notifications from the worker thread that something has changed. So what is the purpose here? Well, JavaScript has the ability to run code asynchronously, but it doesn't allow you to run scripts concurrently. So for things like APIs, that's great. It allows you to be able to make calls out to external sources and be able to execute other code while that's running and set up promises and callbacks to execute when that data returns. But this actually allows data to be run concurrently within the browser. So applications can go and have some very process-intensive tasks take place while the main thread is executing and pull in that data when it's ready. Web workers allow you to spawn additional workers to handle this processing and avoid code that blocks your program from executing. So this is an important point. You do not want your application to run into some very process-intensive task and for it to block execution of your program. So this is a great way of handling that and being able to run that very process-intensive code without interfering with the application. So what do they do? Well, they allow you to run multi-threaded code concurrently in your environment. They allow you to run processes that are non-blocking, don't rely on asynchronous calls, and they implement most of the features that you come to expect from JavaScript, like XML HTTP requests, timers, navigator, most of the array prototypes, most of the things that you would expect in the browser you have access to. There are some differences, though. The couple that I would point out is they don't have access to the window object, and they don't allow you to manipulate the DOM because they basically run in their own scope. And we'll take a look at that in the code example. They cannot be used to bypass cross-origin. They're held to the same restrictions of cross-origin policy that other applications are within JavaScript. So let's take a look at the implementation here. What we have here is a index.html that we're going to set up as a boilerplate. And this is where we are going to pull in our script. This script is going to be our main thread, which will ultimately be where we call our worker function. So the way that the web workers are implemented is it is going to have a post message and an on message. The post message is what we're going to use to send data from the main application to the thread or from the thread back to the main application. The on message is what we're going to use to listen to see if any data has been sent. Now, what we're going to do here is we're going to start work on our main thread, and we are going to initially check to make sure that the worker object is supported. So we check to see if its worker is defined in the global scope of the window. And if it is, we're going to execute our code. In a production environment, you would obviously want to put something to handle when the window object does not contain worker, so it's not defined globally. And for this one, though, we're just going to execute the code. Now, once we establish that the worker is available in the global scope, we go ahead and create a new worker. And that new worker we're going to call M. And M, we're going to have to use this object anytime we're referencing the worker from within our main thread. Now, this worker is actually going to be a reference to another JavaScript file hosted on the server. So the same way that we would reference a JavaScript within our index.html, we're going to reference it in the parameter here for creating the new worker. So let's go ahead and create a new file. And this is going to be the worker.js, where we're going to put all of the code that's going to be handled in the thread. And this is going to reside within the same folder. And it is going to handle any of the post messages that we send to the worker. Now we have a post message. So the post message, this is our function that we're going to use to send data from our main thread to our subthread. And we're just going to pass it a message that says hello from the main thread. Be nice and friendly. Now, within the worker thread, we are going to set up a onMessage function. Now, the onMessage function can just be run in the global scope because we are within the worker itself. So we don't need to define the object of the worker because that was already handled for us when we created the worker in the main thread. So onMessage is going to be equal to a function. That function is going to accept a parameter called E. And E is going to contain any data that gets sent to onMessage, as well as a lot of other metadata around it. So let's take a look at what that object is that gets passed to us. I'm just going to console that object back to the console here. So let's open up our localhost and take a look at our web workers directory. Pull open our debugging tools, look at the console, and it's pushing an event, a message event, back to the page. And that is going to contain a bunch of information about the message itself, as well as the data that's contained within. And you can see in the data, hello from the main thread. So we only want to access that data, so let's just console the data itself back to the page. And let's refresh that. And what we should see is hello from the main thread. And that's running from within the worker thread. Ideally, what we want to do is we want that worker thread to process the data in some way and then send a message back to the main thread. So we do this in much the same way. Just as when we were passing data from the main thread to the worker thread, we can conversely, after the processing of the data is done on the web worker, we can pass that data back to the main thread using the same post message. Unlike in the main thread, we again don't need to reference an object because we're running this within the global scope of the web worker itself. We're just going to send a message back saying hello from the worker thread. And this is that whole observer method that I was talking about. So we're creating the on message. That's what we're doing to register a listener within our our various threads, and the post message is what's communicating to our individual threads. So what we want to do is now we want to add an on message into our main thread as well. We're going to do that within the conditional statement here because we don't want that executing on browsers that don't support the worker object. We're going to reference the M object since this is now running within the global scope of the window, not within the global scope of the thread. We're going to pass E to the function, E being the value that was sent in the post message, and we'll console log out the data that's being sent back. And doesn't look like it came through yet. I think it might have to save that other file here. Let's save that. Make sure that everything's up to date. Refresh, and now we get both messages, hello from the main thread and hello from the worker thread. So we can see we've got that communication between the two threads. We can see the data being passed, and in a real life situation, what you would want to do is you'd want to, you know, maybe pass an array of data to your web worker, and then within that web worker, you would do some processing of that data. Maybe you'd be taking averages or, you know, whatever process intensive work you need to do with it. You would process it within that object, and then you would send it back to the main thread. As far as browser support, it's pretty widely supported in IE 11 and up. Edge, Safari, Chrome, all of the major browsers, all of the modern versions of the major browsers, and it's pretty much available to you now. So this is something that's you should probably understand. You can see a lot of web applications are already using this, so it's really important to have a good solid understanding of what the use cases for when this would be valuable are. And hopefully this was helpful to you. Feel free to subscribe, post messages in the comments, follow me on Twitter, get your questions over to me. I love questions. I love talking about this stuff. So, let's make sure that we do what we can to help you get a solid understanding of this, and look forward to you in the next screencast. Thank you.